the past 70 years, rose gardens across North America have been plagued by an unknown contagious disease. Alma Laney has spent his time at the University of Arkansas as a plant pathologist, working to solve the mystery of this disease, which is known as Rose Rosette. Laney has been able to link the disease to a virus and determine what the virus looks like.
This disease has been devastating for those who love cultivated roses, and it has also been a problem in wild roses. There's not much that can be done for a rose bush once it's been infected with the disease. Rose Rosette was seen in California in the early 1940s. Within a few years, it wiped out the susceptible rose populations that were there.
Although the disease has been around for several decades, it wasn't until the 1950s that the connection was made between Rose Rosette and the presence of a specific type of rose, the multiflora rose.
So up until that time, most of the cases of Rose Rosette were seen in ornamental plantings. With the vast distribution of multiflora rose, Rose Rosette has spread like wildfire throughout the southern part of the country and has spread up into the north and is currently expanding its range, which is tied to the multiflora rose.
An infected rose does not always show symptoms. However, once the symptoms appear, the presence of the virus becomes very obvious.
Some of the common symptoms are uncontrolled growth. There'll be elongated shoots coming out from the canes. There'll be excessive thorniness on some of the cultivated cultivars. That means the entire stem will be covered with thorns. There's also proliferation of the leaves at the nodes on the cane, and some of the structures form a type of witch's broom at the end, with elongated stems and then leaves at the end.
To test for the virus, Laney inserts a rose leaf into a grinder to produce a sap. He then adds different stages of buffer to extract nucleic acids. The nucleic acids are used to create multiple copies of DNA, which then can be used to determine the presence or absence of the virus using a technique called PCR.
I don't think that Rose Rosette will go anywhere, because unfortunately it's currently tied to multiflora rose, and since that rose is able to reseed and replenish the plants that were killed off due to the disease, the two are hand in hand, and as long as there's multiflora rose, this disease is going to be around.
Now that scientists know what the virus looks like, they can work to educate gardeners and nursery owners on how to prevent the spread of Rose Rosette.